Rafael Fernandez Guzman raises tilapia in the Mexican state of Chiapas. He sells them fresh from his ponds to customers who stop by. He sold 230,000 fish in 2009, he says. Now he wants to branch into native species like Mayan cichlids and bay snooks because his customers like them.
Y cuando vienen a comprar tilapia siempre preguntan que si no tenemos castarrica o que si no tenemos otro tipo de mojarra, ¿no?
The problem is, though, that he's not sure if the fish would be as lucrative as the non-native tilapia, which grow faster and are ready for market in 6 months. As Fernandez knows, the longer fish take to mature, the more money he has to spend on feeding them. To help fish farmers like Fernandez, researchers at the autonomous Juarez University of Tabasco in Villahermosa are trying to shave off some of this time. Through selective breeding, they're working to develop a prolific broodstock of Mayan cichlids and bay snooks, which aren't actually related to snooks. They hope these broodstock will produce fast-growing, meaty, consistently sized youngsters that could compete economically with tilapia. Researchers say they chose these two species because they fetch higher prices than tilapia in local markets, consumers like them, and fish farmers want to raise native species because of their popularity. If it successfully develops a genetically improved breeding stock, the university would aim to sell their offspring to fish farmers in southeastern Mexico. So far, the scientists have produced one generation of each species. They intend to make more crosses until they create a stable third generation of broodstock whose progeny will have a competitive edge. At one of the university's campuses, their work is in full swing thanks in part to funding from the U.S. Agency for International Development through its Aquafish Collaborative Research Support Program. Dozens of mesh cages holding Mayan cichlids and bay snooks float in two ponds. They are the descendants of nearly 200 wild fish. Students weigh and measure them and weed out the small ones. They'll keep an elite group of the heaviest ones, then breed them and repeat the selection process until they arrive at the third generation. One day, their offspring just might end up at Rafael Fernandez's fish farm.